young man selling canned bread heard the organ playing. He came in and listened, stood behind the organist, and the organist soon stopped and told him that he was welcome to listen. And eventually, Robert Haldane said, "Would you like to study the organ?" And at that time, he did. And it was the beginning of a long career in music for Ronald Sider. In fact, his cousin Mary Fretz, who is here this evening, said that she was in grade 13 in the Dunnville High School, and she would come over and listen to Ron practice. He would practice over his lunch break when he was selling Canada bread. He sold bread for one whole year in 7 summers, and that was what largely helped to pay his bill at the Eastman School of Music. This 90th birthday concert allows Ron to celebrate his birthday with his Canadian relatives and friends. In appreciation for the role that St. Paul's has played in his long career, the offering this evening, the free will offering, will be donated to St. Paul's in appreciation to them. Thank you so much for coming, and we hope you enjoy the concert.
Thank you. composer of the next piece, Ely Willen, was a famous Canadian composer and organist. He had a church down in Toronto, a big church, I think an Anglo-Catholic church, and my father went to hear him play and spoke with him after the service and always enjoyed playing his music. So we thought it would be only appropriate here in Canada to play a piece by a Canadian composer. So I've chosen a beautiful setting of him.
Thank you. music. They didn't have a jazz program. They didn't teach that because the prevailing theory at the time was jazz couldn't be taught. There were a lot of students, though, at the time that my dad would be in classrooms and see in the halls that they were learning jazz on their own. They were playing jazz on the weekends. They were studying jazz privately. People like Chuck Mangione, who recorded his first album while he was at Eastman. Lou Soloff, who was a great trumpet player, who 10 years after leaving Eastman was playing at Woodstock in front of 400,000 people. And Ron Carter, who hadn't recorded at all when he was at Eastman. By now, I think he has been recorded over 2,000 times. Several decades later, when I was fortunate enough to graduate Berklee College of Music with a jazz performance degree, as luck would have it, Ron Carter was commencement speaker. My sister and I are going to play a jazz tunes arrangement of an old African American spiritual called Do Lord Remember Me.
Thank you.
Wakeman Williams is a beautiful setting of a hymn tune that my dad also played on his 1964 concert here at St. Paul's. And although it's originally written for solo organ, we have arranged it for the three of us to play together.
Thank you.
covers, and he has played it many times. The first movement is loud and majestic, with a fugue in the middle. The second movement is soft and lyrical. He played it for years in the weekly radio broadcast, Music from Versailles College.
Thank you.
in 1956, which he played in his organ recital here in 1964. This piece was also written for my dad. It was written and dedicated to him by his friend Bert Carlson, whom he attended Messiah College with. Bert was a prolific composer who had many pieces published, and this is a beautiful setting of the Swedish hymn that will be made.
Thank you.
always enjoyed having a, what we call a family band. And always took place on New Year's Eve, if no other time during the year, when they were young, they played percussion instruments. And then they learned to play the violin, and now we can all participate on our instruments. So we're going to close the concert tonight with "Oh, for a Thousand Tongues to Sing." And it seems only appropriate that we would include you in our family band. So we're going to play it several times, and then we're all going to sing it. And if you would look for the hymnal that says Common Praise, and in Common Praise, it's 306. 306. And we're going to do the first and the last stanza. And it is not this tune that is in the hymnal. It's the tune, it's an alternate tune. So you'll catch on to it by the time that you hear it. And it will be the fourth and fifth time that we play it. And I'll signal you when it's time for you to sing. And it seems only appropriate that we end with giving praise to God, who has given us the talent and has given us music to enjoy and to enrich our lives. And so we'll end by giving praise to God. So, oh, 4,000 tongues to sing, and you will sing the first and fifth stanza.
Thank you.